Welcome to this video on basic search techniques in SharePoint 2013. One of SharePoint's most important features is its fast and efficient search engine. This video shows you basic techniques such as entering queries, sorting, and filtering so you can quickly find what you need. You can also monitor changes to content by setting an alert on search results. On the homepage of Inside NCDOT, we'll begin by looking for information on the new e-signature process. Enter e-signatures in the search box and click the search button. Search returns results from both Inside NCDOT and Connect NCDOT. Although there are no results in this example, search will also return results from your team sites on Inside NCDOT, your project and team sites on Connect NCDOT, and NCDOT.gov, the public-facing website for NCDOT. The bottom of the results page gives the total number of results. In our example, there are about 291. You may get a different number because your SharePoint permissions determine what you can see. Let's go back to the top of the page and look at a result in detail. Each result has an icon to tell you the type of file. It has a title that is a link to the content. That content might be a file, a web page, an email, an image, or a drawing. Whatever has been stored on SharePoint and includes the text you are searching for. To open the content, simply click the link. For files and web pages, you'll see an excerpt from the content with the matching text in bold. This is the URL, which is the path to the content. The remaining properties include authors, date, and file size. If you hover over a result, you'll see a pop-up with author, date, and commands to open the content, send a link in email, and view the source library. The commands vary with permissions. Once you've done an initial search and are on the search results page, there are options for sorting the results. The default order of search results is relevance, which uses SharePoint algorithms to determine the ranking. The newest date displays the most recent results on top, while the oldest date reverses that order. Lifetime views is by order of popularity, and recent views is comparable to a trending topics rating. All of these options return the same 291 results, just in a different order. Let's return to the sort order of relevance. On the search results page, you can use the refiners in the left column to refine or filter the results. Let's see what's available under business content type. For example, if you were looking for training materials related to e-signatures, either online training materials or training materials and aids would be good filters to try. If we click on Training Materials and Aids, we see one PDF for a training module. Click All to clear the filter and display all business content types again. If you know the file format of the material you're looking for, use File Type. For example, click PDF to see about 45 results. Click All to return to all file types. If you know the approximate date of the material you're seeking, and if the sort order of newest date or oldest date was not helpful, try the Modified Date slider to narrow the number of results. If we try a modified date of 1 month ago, there are about 15 results. Clear the filter. If you know the author of the material you're looking for, use the Author Refiner. Suppose we know that Michael Holder is an author. If you don't see his name in the initial results, click Show More to see additional authors. Here's Michael, so we'll click his name to see the e-signature document that he authored. Again, click All to clear the refiner. You can also filter documents by data security classification if they have been tagged as either unrestricted or restricted. In this case, there is only unrestricted material available. Because tagging is a current and ongoing process, only 5 of the files have been tagged as unrestricted so far. Click All to clear the filter. Finally, before the recent introduction of business content types, you may have previously tagged materials with type. If so, you can use that as a refiner. For example, click Item to see items in a list with the term e-signature. Open up one of the results to see the properties of that item. Return to the search results page and clear the filter. You can apply multiple refiners, such as searching for a PDF by a certain author. Under File Type, click PDF, and under Author, click Show More, then Michael Holder. You'll then see the PDF where he's listed as an author. Let's clear the filters. Due to space limitations, no more than 9 values are displayed for any refiner. So, for example, if there are hundreds of results, you will only see up to 9 authors, even if there are many more. If you search for the term e-signatures on Connect NCDOT, you'll get the same 291 results in the same order of relevance. However, you may notice a few differences. The URL does not appear in the search results. There is an additional refiner of file size, and the refiners are in a different order. On Inside NCDOT, you can set an alert on search results. This means that your search query is saved, and if its results change, you'll receive an email. For example, you might want to set an alert if you are interested in knowing about new developments about e-signatures. Let's go back to our results page for e-signatures on Inside NCDOT. Scroll to the bottom of the page and click Alert Me. The alert has a default title of Search e-signatures, which is fine for this example. The delivery method is email, and your email address is automatically retrieved. Choose whether you want to know about new results, modified results, or both. We'll go with all changes. And we'd like our alert as a daily summary. Click OK. When you create an alert, you'll receive an email notification. I previously set up an alert for the search on e-signature, so I'd have some examples to show. Here's the email I received that confirmed my alert was successfully created. Click My Alerts on this site, then the name of the alert. You'll see I identified this alert to be a daily summary of all changes. On this same page, I can edit or delete my alert. Now, let's go back to my email to look at an example of the alert. At the top of the daily summary, you have options to view, edit, or delete your alerts. And if you click Go to Search Results, you'll rerun the search. This is a link to the file that was changed. You can click it to open the file. On Connect NCDOT, you can set an alert only if you're logged in and have an Active Directory account. External users of Connect NCDOT can only create alerts on project sites to which they belong. In this video, you've learned about basic query, sort, and filter techniques in SharePoint 2013 Search. You've also seen how to set an alert on search results. There are 2 companion videos that describe advanced search techniques, so take a look at them once you're comfortable with this material. We encourage you to check out our other SharePoint videos, as well as the reference and training materials on the SharePoint Help site. On Connect NCDOT, there is a link to help on every page. Go to the main help page and click SharePoint Help to see the SharePoint Help information. On Inside NCDOT, there is a link to the help site in the header and footer of every page. Those links also take you to the SharePoint Help site. For information on upcoming SharePoint classes, log in to Beacon and check the LMS training calendar, or contact the PC training group. Thanks for watching.